In moments like those, I've often wondered, why do I need to become a monitor for male behaviour? Why don't I leave well alone and settle for a quiet life? It would be easier. But I've worked hard to find a voice, and I want to keep it and use it. Opportunities to build friendships and networks and to think differently don't often come as well orchestrated and managed as the Future Directions Conference. And those networks have survived in various forms to this day. The conference was also my introduction to scenario planning, a technique where you think about the different scenarios that may occur and how you will respond to them. I have used scenario planning many times since. There were 5 scenarios planning sessions offered at the conference. Connection with the Asian region. Growth of high technology. Growth in knowledge-based industries. Feminization of Australia and a belief that they, that is men, would not change the world. Convivial equity, which imagined a shared definition of the future where power and responsibility were shared in pursuit of the greater good. Of the 114 participants, 35, including me, were attracted to the convivial equity scenario. It reflected a very Australian vision, which many of us have since pursued. It is now 40 years since that conference. I realise how prescient it was. The 5 scenarios have all occurred in one way or another. The session inspired us to take responsibility, as we had to run the session ourselves. People who attended that conference still find they are working on the same issues in Australia. Most have provided leadership and added value to Australian society.